Good afternoon. I am going to discuss a major topic that is technical English. Under this topic, I will discuss word formation. How a word is accountable in a sentence. I will have a scientific approach because technical course that is a course is not regional, it is a global. And the globe demands scientific approach of learning. So how will you learn scientifically what is a word? So science demands, scientific inquiry demands, and according to the natural philosophy of science claimed by C.G. Hempel of Princeton University, America. He claims that scientific inquiry is ramified into two parts, empirical and non-empirical. And under empirical, the concept or data must be verified either in lab or through data. And in lab we have physical event, chemical event, psycho and clinical. But language is not concerned with this, language is concerned with data. So data must be attested in nature. Once data is not attested, we cannot verify the concept is right or wrong. So I will have the minimal meaningful unit of a word, that is called morpheme. Morpheme is divided into two parts, free morpheme and bound morpheme. Free morpheme is distinguished through sentence. I will come to the sentence and I will tell what is free morpheme. Under the bound morpheme, we have all affixes. Affixes is prefix, suffix, infix, circumfix and superfix. And English word, generally our student claims that what is word? What students say that word is a combination of letters. And our teaching and learning is student oriented. We are bound to respect the thought of our student. And accordingly, we are also bound to verify. How will we verify the thought of the learners? Learners claim that the word is called combination of letters. But here, we have attested data. Attested data is this is a book. Why it is attested? Because we find this data in LKG, UKG books of Oxford University Press, Cambridge University Press. That's why we claim that the data is attested. Okay. This is a book. Once I tell our student, count how many number of words are there. A student will tell, number of words are 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then, is it justified? Your concept is justified against the data? Then he will be confused. He or she will tell, no sir. Why? Because this is the combination of letters, it is also combination of letters, book is also combination of letters, but A is not a combination of letters. So our concept, our thought requires rectification. What does it require? All letters or combination of letters is called word. Okay. So here we have defined the word. Further, we will ramify, we will classify the types of words. Simple, compound and complex. And these ramifications are global in nature, not regional, because it is accepted by Stanford also, Harvard also, and MIT also. So we find in the material of MIT, Harvard, these are the classification. Let us have example of simple. What is a simple? Once we write boy, once we write girl, we claim that this is a simple word. Simple word is always free from affixes. We don't find any kind of bond morpheme here. And we claim that all kinds of free morphemes. All kinds of free morphemes are called simple word. Let us come to the second. What is compound? Compound word is made of more than two or more than two simple words. But thing is that we will not have any kind of affixes, neither prefix, nor suffix, nor even infix, circumfix and superfix. We don't include all these affixes into compound. Why? Why we don't include? Because the definition of compound is it is made of simple only and simple more than two simple words. More than two simple words are forming compound words. Okay, let us take an example. A blackboard. We claim that a blackboard is a simple word. Sorry, it's a compound word. Why it is a compound word? Because it is the combination of three simple words. Compound, these are three simple words. And complex, let us come to complex, then we will distinguish simple, compound and complex. We ask the student, what is this word A? The student says, that A is a simple word. Why? Why A is a simple word? Because they count that the single word. No, this is wrong. Once students claim that this R is a complex, it is a simple, it is a wrong, it is a complex word. Why is it a complex? Because once we say what? Why is attached with the affix? Affix is S. It is also called suffix. Okay. So here R. R is the plural form of it. It is changed into R. Based on the analogy, of plural property, we claim that each is the simple word and R is the complex word. R is not compound. R is not compound because R is affixed with the feature of plural form.